Lamar.
Pride!
Pride! Pride!
Thank you.
My name is Scott Pierce. And yeah.
Tell me, what are you doing here today out in Castro Valley, California?
I'm just, you know, trying to support the gay community. I'm a straight kid, and, you know, I came also to, you know, perform and, you know, just, you know, get the word out about, you know, gay pride in Castro Valley, you know, because Castro Valley's, you know, like, it's a town that, you know, normally doesn't, you know, it's kind of redneck, doesn't normally support, like, you know, gay rights, and, you know, now that we finally got this together, I'm really glad that, you know, how big the turnout was, and, you know, how many supporters we have here. You know, it's good to see that, you know, that, you know, there is pride in Castro Valley.
Is there bullying that goes on at this high school?
Not really. But, you know, there are some people who are against, you know, homosexuality here.
How about you?
Okay, my name is Holly Zeitz. I'm part of the three that started
three.
This whole thing.
What did you guys do today? What did you accomplish?
Today we made a big impact on the community. We made a lot of people happy. We made a lot of money for next year to make it bigger and better to have a parade. We made ourselves happy. We made a lot of people feel welcome. We made a lot of people feel like Castro Valley is a lot more supportive than it may have come off as before. So as an ally, I think that we made that happen. We saw a lot of supporters. A lot of people came up to us and said thank you for doing this. And everyone that came here is so awesome. Like, just everyone that came is just fantastic for showing up. So.
Well, the other young man just told me that he didn't think there was bullying at Castro Valley High. So what was the purpose of getting a rally together today? Do you experience bullying, or do you have friends that experience bullying, or is this just in response to all the things that are going on around the country or the world?
We did it for many reasons. I think it's impacted the Bay Area as a whole a lot more than just the town. I lost my train of thought for a second. I'm sorry.
I don't know. You guys can jump in at any minute, too.
Yeah. Just stop like, for a second while I think.
Like, why bother to do this, you know?
They broke the ice.
Yeah. How did they break the ice?
Well, as you said, Castro Valley is kind of known to be a redneck town. I'm representing the cowgirls of the town. I went to Castro Valley High School. I mean, that's amazing. I would have never thought that somebody would do this or have the guts to do it. And they're amazing, so we're just out here to support them.
How long ago were you at this high school?
Do you really want me to say?
You know, okay, so.
Well, let me see.
What was the difference?
I graduated in 83.
It's okay.
Just, I mean.
What was the atmosphere then?
I didn't know a lot of gay people. I knew a couple of them, and I was supportive. And I know that there's just, I think it's just people don't understand. You know, they get mixed messages. They think that when you have this guy all dressed up, that represents the gay community, and it doesn't. Everybody I know is just, you know, your average kid, adult, mom, dad, whatever, and we're just all here having a good time. So when you see something like this, you see a lot of people come out like that, and which is cool, but there's a lot of people. I know police officers that were here, fire department. We had, the businesses I told wanted to jump on helping these people. So it was just awesome. And a lot of people don't think that Castro Valley is like that.
Yeah.
So.
What do you think was your biggest influence to do this today? And I'm wondering, just because I'm curious, I'm a fan of Glee. Is that anything that influenced you or other things, other popular?
The idea, yeah, we never expected it to get this big, which is, so it's like incredible that it even came this far. We just originally just wanted to do it for fun and just kind of tell people, whoever would drive by, we were just like going to have like 15 or 20 people running down the boulevard with signs and stuff. We just wanted to do a little bit to make as much of an impact as we felt we could, and it turned out to be something so much bigger than us. So we just wanted to show Castro Valley, hey, we're here, what's up?
Yeah. Growing up here, I mean, I always thought Castro Valley was super close-minded and conservative, and it's not the place to be gay, you know? It's not a place you can question your sexuality, it's not a place you can accept it or be comfortable with it, it's something you should hide. But as I got older, you know, and into high school, and, you know, I meet people like Frankie and like Holly, and I realized, you know, there is actually this community here, and you know, Castro Valley's a lot more diverse than people actually, you know, give it credit for. And I know there's probably a lot of kids out there, you know, LGBT kids who are uncomfortable with it because they think Castro Valley is a super, you know, conservative place. But I wanted to do this to show the kids that that's not the case, that there are people like you and people who will support you for whoever you are.
Do you think anything's going to be different on Monday morning? Oh, I'm sorry, we're in the summer. I don't even know if there's summer school going on, but do you think that this will affect September when you start back up again? You're one of the main organizers, right, Frankie?
Yeah.
You were all over Facebook.
Hoping for positive reviews, I guess. I mean, I don't really know everybody at the school, but I know all my friends are going to be super happy. A lot of them actually showed up, so I kind of know how they took it. Like, they were very proud of me and very excited, and proud of Johnna and Holly as well, but I'm not sure how everybody else is going to take it.
So what would a positive outcome of this today look like for you? How would that present itself?
I think those that are still in the closet might come out and choose to join the GSA, or those who are straight but supportive, and I get kind of closeted supportive, they might join the GSA. But, like, my main goal was to really, like Johnna said, was to show that Castro Valley isn't this, like, scary redneck town. Like, freshman year, I knew I was gay, but I was afraid to come out because I thought that everybody was conservative, Republican, and when I did, like, I was taking a huge risk, and it turns out, like, it's not like that at all. Like, everybody is so supportive, and so, like, I want everybody else to know that.
So today was a huge recruitment tool for the GSA at the school.
Slightly not, that was the whole point.
You know, back in my day, they used to say we were only where we were talking to anybody because we wanted to, quote, recruit others. How does that term affect your life, or do you hear that anymore? I'm not even sure if that's something that's, you know, being joked about.
Or I haven't really heard that. We're definitely not trying to recruit, unless you mean make everyone more accepting of everyone, in which case we're doing that, but it's not like, hey, become gay.
Join us.
Do you like to say anything for the...
I think the fact that this happened, it was just a long time coming. Like, something like this is pretty big for this town. I mean, I think Billy said it was a quiet little town. And, I kind of disagree. It just didn't happen. And when these three teenagers, they decided, hey, I have an idea, let's do something. And they put the event on Facebook, and then people got involved. Everyone was like, yeah, this is the way I have. I was just waiting for someone else to organize it.
So you disagree with what? That it's that the view of Castro Valley is mostly that it's a conservative little...
I feel like there's some people here that need to be exposed to the love and the caring and the normalness of everyone, including gay people and straight people and everyone.
How about you? Are you a mom or just an ally?
And I actually worked at
Castro Valley. She's your mom.
I worked at Castro Valley High School for 7 years, and I can tell you that it is very accepting of gays. There are a large number of gay staff members. They talk about it with their classes. They're very open about it. And I think that it's something that the kids need to be made aware of. They don't need to be afraid.
Hi, I'm Zachary Peterson. I'm going to be a senior. I'm 17, and my thoughts on the It Gets Better campaign is really inspirational. I mean, I watched the video that had Obama, and I just thought that was amazing because he's, like, such a powerful person, and reaching out to something that's so small compared to everything else is just really inspirational. And also listening to Firework by Katy Perry and watching the video, that's just, like, one of the best songs I've ever heard. I get chills whenever I listen to it. And this is really something that, like, motivates me to work really hard and reaching out to the community along with my friends who actually, we have a podcast called Teen Talk on live stream. And every week we try and help teenagers with any questions they have. It can be anything. Like, it could have something to do with the gay community, it could have something to do with high school in general, college, all that stuff. So, like, having something like this gives us something to talk about there and something more to reach out to them for. So, yeah.